Today we have a special guest. His name is...
That's the sky button.
Okay, so what happens if somebody clicks on you?
Actually, in the X775 dimension, you get to save kittens. So every time you subscribe, you save a kitten.
We'll be right back.
Hello there and welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman and today we are doing autosave. Let me show you the demo. Here it is.
It is Le Pikachu.
Walk into the first checkpoint. Okay, so there he is. And we are going to close this. Let's run the application again. And you can see that Pikachu spawns at the 10 point mark. Let's go to the 20 point mark. Okay, there he is. And let's close this. Open it again. And he starts. Let's go to the 30 point mark. Same thing. Let's close it. Reopen it again. And you can see that Pikachu starts. So let's open the example file, which you can find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below where you can download the free version. There's also a link to the pay version, which allows you to create commercial games. Games you can sell. Now, if you click on Pikachu, you can see that he is a platform object. So all the jump and the movement is handled automatic. All you have to do is change the speed, gravity, jump strength, and blah, blah, blah. You can see that this is just a picture. This is my background. This says another background, which I am tiling. I can make this bigger if I wanted to. And we have these objects here, which are just pictures. This could be animated if you wanted to. You can see that all of them are pictures. All right, let's program the autosave. And to do that, we're going to insert an INI object. Right click, insert object, select INI object, place it anywhere you like. Let's go to the event editor. Here are the two events I'm using. Line 2 does the scrolling. And line 3 is the collision with the background. So if Pikachu collides with the first marker, we are going to save the position of Pikachu. At the start of the frame, we're going to set up a file. Let's call this arc 0. You can call it whatever you want. We're also going to load the position of Pikachu. Let's try it out. Let's walk up to the first point. Here it is. Checkpoint 10 has been reached. Close the application. Restart it. And you can see that we start at 10. Let's copy line 4. Paste it. Replace it for 20. We're not going to change anything here. Let's do the same thing for the 30-point mark. Let's try it out. Notice that we start at 10.
Come on, Pikachu, walk faster.
Here's the 20 mark. Reload this again. And you can see that he starts at 20. Let's walk up to 30. 30, 30. Close the game. Run the game again. And you can see that we start at 30. All right, so you can see that this autosaves or use it as checkpoints. All right, so if you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't like the video, please give it a thumbs down. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out my other channel, the Sparkman Vlog. Follow me on Twitter, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.